Dr. Sonal Motta here from the branch of Homeopathy. First, I ask blessings from my teachers, whoever have been in my journey, naming them Dr. Pushpa Chabaria, Dr. Geeta Punjabi, Dr. Munish Vatra, Dr. Prakash Vakil, Usha Ben, and all the gurus, lamas, everyone who have been with me in this journey. Whatever I say will be a sum total of the experience of the patients and the teachings, and even whatever will help you at the best. The title for today is Backache and Homeopathy. When there is ache in the back, there is a backache. What happens that when you were born from the mother's womb, you are totally relaxed? When there is a slightest disturbance in the normalcy of the human body, then the ache sets in. So first, what is very important, my dear friends, listen very carefully and implement every word, that you need to be relaxed. How will you relax? First, if you keep your two hands backwards and take out your tongue, this way you will be relaxed. Second, how will you be relaxed? If you separate your two hands like this and look towards the sky is so large, vast, and stands without support. The Akash Tattva, the emptiness, will enter your system. So, you're going to be totally relaxed. Okay? Now, the third way, I say, you lie down on the floor. Now, this is a Shavasana, but not the normal Shavasana, my dear friends. You lie down like this. Two hands separate, two legs separate, and do not pay attention to the breath or anything, just lie down. Your system will relax, the circulation will improve, your fibrous tissue, inflammation, all work will happen on its own. And there will be a change. So this way you can do. My dear friends, when you say ache, there is a tension created. And where there is tension, where there is stress, the muscle goes into spasm. So, we will make this whole phenomena like this. That the backache that is happening, you got the full spinal cord. In backache, L2, L3, L4, L5, these are the anatomical vertebrae that are affected. So it could be due to stress, one. Number two, due to bad posture. Sorry, please. First, I would take stress. Second, I would take psychology. Third, I would take anger. So these are the very important psychological factors which you need to take cognizance of. Number two, your posture. Number three, your lifestyle. Number four, your eating habits. What kind of occupation you are in, in which city you are in. Then, how, what, it is secondary to what? It could be secondary to gas, constipation, if you are having period problem, if there is a fibroid, if there is a stone, if there is prostate cancer. Now coming to the local area of the backache. If two vertebrae are there and if it is pressing the nerve, it could go into slip disc, or it could be mechanical due to the push or a kick you are giving to the scooter, or it could also be due to the rush in the train, or due to you are standing a long time. Any of the reason it could be, or it could be due to ankylosing spondylitis or PV of vertebra. And if the pain extends down to the nerves, it could go into sciatica. So these are basically all the factors that are there in backache. Now, as far as the psychological factors are concerned, relaxation techniques are shown. If you have anger, you realize you're getting anger. You need to take water, you need to take deep breaths, or go to the loo and speak bad words and complete the situation. Done. Relaxation is shown. Now we go to the factors of posture. You have to sit L-shaped. Don't sit on the sofa like this. No, wrong posture. Sit like this. Now, my dear friends, many ladies, many gents have a big pouch over here, okay? When they have a big pouch, the disc inside will bulge inside and then the pain is created. So your big pouch and obesity, that creates a backache also. In many cases, we have seen obesity, there is loose flesh at the back side and in the front side. So the tone of the muscles is affected and the pain comes. Okay, now we came to the posture, type of sitting. Now suppose you are in a sitting job, what you do? Okay, you have said, take a walk like this and sit down again. Okay, and the exercise to be done at that time. This we have found to be very effective in many, many cases. Like this, hold your hand and you breathe out. Ha. 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 Like this you have to do, my dear friends, 100 times. We have got limitation of time and a lot to cover up. This will really help out, and this is result oriented. In one program where I was, I got a feedback from a patient. They wrote to me, I didn't meet. They said, 2 years we spent doing lot of treatment, but this I followed and I had a lot of change. What I had told in that program was, you drink a lot of water. Another instruction will just come. And don't have sour food, kokum, imli and nimbu. That made a change, because with this exercise the muscle tone improves, the circulation improves, the spasm that is coming will become down. Now, I forgot to tell you that in the Shavasana that we did, one experience we had about maybe 20 years back when we were doing a seminar at Prempuri Ashram, first floor, about 100 people were there. One gentleman said he was asked to be operated, but this Shavasana when we did, he had excellent results. Within 20 days, his back pain became zero. And my conclusion of experience is, relaxation will cause blood circulation, spasm becoming less, mind becoming zero, and the result coming. We did not say, wear a belt, don't do this, don't do that, nothing. He just did this and he had left his job. These are profound, experienced exercises that will definitely help. But my dear friends, your sincerity, your dedication, your consistency is the key to the solution. Now I was talking about posture. Then comes your lifestyle, what you are eating, junk food, non-veg food. We are first coming to the causes, and the diet also I am taking. If you are going to eat all non-veg stuff, You are putting junk. System can't take up. And gas will form and backache will come. And I'm sorry to say, you will keep on taking painkillers, but you will not find out that it is due to gas. One example again, that was many years back. I'm repeating this example. That gentleman was asked to be operated at the back, but when we were called, simple enema was given to that 85-year-old gentleman. He passed a lot of gas and the pain was better. So, when the symptoms come, you have to see the root cause. If you are able to be one with your body, with awareness, then the patient itself can look at the cause. So, when the symptom comes, if your mind is in panickiness and fear, doctor has told surgery, now what to do, MRI is showing like this, what to do, it is showing ankylosing spondylitis. The first thing is that you have to be very cool, calm and relaxed to be able to find the right person to guide you. Because where attention goes, there you will be able to find the right person. But if you are panickiness in confusion, you will go to 5 people. But if you find the right person, you will follow one direction, experience that, then go to the next person. So my dear friends, the first state of mind I would like you to have is totally cool and calm. Now here you will say, I am suffering with pain. You are not suffering. I am eating constant medicine. 5 medicines I take. My pain doesn't go. How you are saying to do that? But I am telling you, you write everything in a paper, that energy of your stress will go to the paper, it will not travel to the back. So that will reduce your anxiety level and that also the pain and the muscle will relax. Then you will come to know the real picture. Because all MRI and everything is catching, it has developed 1 year back and it is catching right now. So you become afraid. So you need to relax. And I have already told you the methods which I have experienced to relax. So first is, relax is very important because your circulation will improve. That is one. Now third, I said menses pain. Yes. But that is a different topic altogether. Along with homeopathic, along with other exercises, it will help. Fibroids is another issue altogether, but I am mentioning the cause. Kidney stone, yes. In kidney, even if cyst is there, yes. TB infection, there will be a prolonged pain. Ankylosing spondylitis, yes, the pain will be there. But that also we have helped. It is actually gone also. And also cases where, when TB is there, no, you have to take your TB medication. I will not say that no, it will help. Prostate cancer also will give back pain. And even fracture of the vertebra will give back pain. So all these causes we are summing up together. Now remember, my dear friends, if in secondary causes you are having sugar, back pain to go will take a long time. So you are having additional thing to be looked at. So you have to work with sugar also, you have to work with the ache also. So depending upon the causes that are there, the treatment will be there. I would like to say that even in cases where slip disc is there and sciatica is there, you know, the vertebra are like this and the nerve is being pressed and the legs are getting numbness, I'll just show you one exercise. The importance of showing the exercise is, because when the patient comes, we look at the patient holistically. When you are making a dal, you put the ghee, you put the hing, you put the rye, you put everything together and then make the dal. So the holistic approach is a naturopathic approach where totally the patient can be relieved, and in my experience I have seen that they can be relieved much more faster you even you take help of everything and finally be on your own. You learn how to help yourself, and there is no need to die with back pain. No, you will not die with back pain. You need to have the correct approach systematically, understand your system, and then apply it. So application, understanding is important, and everything has got its own value at the given level. And I would like to add here one thing, that body has got a refined capacity to heal itself. So if you make a mindset over here, all your message will go to the trillion DNAs that are there. Everything will get aligned automatically. So your mindset, my dear friends, is important. What you are paying attention to. I will come to this. I will first show you the exercise of back pain, which I want to show. I will be covering up homeopathy also, my dear friends. Beautiful exercise for back pain. You lie down like this with two legs separate. You know, you can lie down 10 minutes, 15 minutes. The circulation will improve, the spasm will improve. There will be improvement in the muscle tone also because you are lying down. This cannot be done during tears. Now, another thing I would like to add is that whenever you are having this, I have actually narrated all the causes to you. You have to see, I'm going to the diet part, my dear friends. In the diet part, whenever you wake up early in the morning, take 2 glasses of water. Take 3 glasses of water. Let them be warm water. You may add haldi to it and take tulsi and neem. Neem is antibacterial, antiviral. Your immunity power will improve. Haldi is anti-inflammatory. You may take tea, take some dry fruits, whatever you want. Then take lot of fruits. Take a lot of fruits, about 1/2 kg. That will help your digestion. Another thing is that when you are eating food, my suggestion is to ban chapatis, to take najni ka roti, take all sorts of bhajis you like, take everything you like, but importance to lambi singhi soup. In Hindi we call it sarakwa ka singh, uska soup. That will help for the bony pains. Nachni ka roti, juwar ka roti, ya chawal ka roti. Whichever is okay with you. Now another thing I would like to add. If you are having lot of heat in the body and if you have acidity, please do not take bajri. And take vegetable, dal, dahi. Do not take chawal in the afternoon. In the evening time, you may take some mixture of either beet, palak, tomato. If that is not palatable, take. I usually put my patients on millets. From millets, you can make idli, dosa, everything. And in the evening, you may take millets or rice, again with vegetable soup, again two 2 glasses of hot water in the night, or you take, my one patient I just gave, 1 glass of milk with honey, with haldi, and 2 teaspoonful of ghee. Honey, haldi, 2 teaspoonful of ghee, so even your stools will be better. Point is that you are not dependent on any medication, because everything is containing chemical. Your natural tendency can improve. And see that you take at least 8 glasses of water. In between, take nariyal pani, take buttermilk. Now, many persons may be having a habit of drinking. Many people may be taking your gurkha. Many persons may be taking fish. Many persons looking at this video may be from abroad, used to all non-veg stuff. Your question is, non-veg we should not eat. My belief is that if I put a knife over here, I go into terror. When I go into terror, that energy is going into my system and creating another vibration into all the organs. And that will interact with all the organs of my body. And that will again create another disease. Not another disease, I will not say like this. But your metabolism will have extra work to do. Here we are having, one is immunity power, then second is disease energy. The disease energy is fighting with the wisdom energy and the immunity energy. So when your immunity and wisdom energy of God within you will increase, and your exercise and everything will improve, then the disease energy will go down. And this can happen with the help of proper diet, environment, exercise, lifestyle, mindset. So only that will help. So here, if you are taking non-veg, you may take, but see that you take in ghee, one. Number two, take, if you really can't be without it, take once a week, take twice a week, take limited. Because finally, it is, your body is the gift of God to you on this earth. For the taste of the tongue, you are damaging your internal metabolism, and how much will it compensate? How much will the compensation you want from the natural phenomena? And many people, see, all police and everyone are there. They are staying on the road and everything. They are holding heavy weight also, they are not getting anything, because lifestyle is very simple. They are very happy, your tension is not there. So you need to implement this. And my humble request to all human beings and humanity on earth, eat food that is required for the organs of the body and not for the taste of the food. If you will start eating, and even if you will have a desire to know what organs require what food, it will come in front of you automatically. You don't need to go and find it. Actually, it will come. And if you start consuming those foods, your body will start repairing itself, because body itself has got the repairing power. Medicines will supplement it. Food will supplement it. Your mind, mental attitude will supplement it. And don't be caught by the name of the disease. The name can be very big, but it is not big, bigger than, it's not going to give you death. It will not. And pain is only an alarm that you need to look into your body. The question is that you have not given importance to your body. I'm very sorry to say, human beings, my friends, my fathers, my mothers, my dada, my dadi, whoever is listening, whatever you are listening or whatever you are taking, due respect and due timing to the body is not given. You will either say, I have got guest, I have got work, repair work is there, someone is dead, I have to do. But if proper timing, you will give proper treatment to your body will never be so bad. Because nature wants you to be healthy. And you are the best creation of the Lord on this human earth. So it's up to you how you take action for your body. It's only an alarm that you need to pay. It's not so bad. Surgery comes only when you've not paid enough attention. First alarm comes, second alarm, third alarm, change. And whenever you need to change, you need to come to the habit pattern. So habit pattern, what you have to do? Just close your eyes, be relaxed and visualize that your habit has already changed. So when you will visualize your habit has already changed, you will see knowingly, unknowingly, it will automatically change. But at least start visualizing that. Take your God's name and visualize. You visualize your pain is better. Actually, it will start happening. Things start happening only by thinking about it. Because mind has got such an atom bomb power. All the pathologies in the body also can change. Along with the combination of everything, all medicines also will have its own power. In cases of cancer, in cases of TB, yes, medication will be required. In cases of lordosis, in cases where people are walking with a stick, they walk like this, they can be made like this, but provided you decide. I've got ladies, they say, humko sharam aata hai lakdi ka support leke chalne ko. Sharam kyun aata hai? Kharaap lagta hai. Kharaap kisse lagta hai? Kisko dikhane ka hai? Body ki jarurat hai, you have to walk like this. They feel bad about it. This is not okay with us. If you have to wear a patta for a support at the back, no, we are not okay. This is happening, that is happening. You have to be open and take it, digest it and implement it. Then the change will come, my friends. Again, coming to this, that ache is very easy and simple. Now coming to the homeopathic angle. Homeopathy is such a beautiful science that Samir Hanuman has made. Whatever medicines are made from the animal kingdom, mineral kingdom, plant kingdom. The medicine's name I may say right away, but usage can only be with the help of the qualified doctor. The combination could be taken. Because how the selection of the medicine is done so beautifully, my dear friends, that when the medicine produces that type of symptom, then that medicine is potentized and given to the patient. Example, I'm just giving an example out of the box. Like if you're taking onion, you are cutting the onion, you will get watering of the eyes. That medicine is called Arium Sipa in homeopathy. So when that medicine in potentized form is given, it can be given to burning of your nostrils, eyes burning and watering to cure cold at that level. So the rule says similia similibus curantur. So on these principles medicines are made. Now combination of medicines or selection of medicines, my dear friends, will depend upon the causative factor. But first, belladonna is used mainly for the pain. Naksomika is used when stools are not proper and the pain comes. Pulsatilla is used when it is with periods. Number 4, a combination or maybe Rustox Ruta when a strain is there. Rustox when pain increases in the rainy season. Again, when pain comes in the winter season, we have a different medicine, my dear friends. Then when the nerve is pressing and the pain is due to a dhakka on the scooter, Arnika will come, or you have banged with a wall. Accordingly, the medicine will be different. Suppose with the back pain you are having a sciatica, it will go into colocynth or lachesis, either left or right, the pain, the selection of the medicine will be very different. For numbness also medicine will be different. That is why I am not naming all the medications. And another thing, my dear friends, we also give combination of biochemic remedies like calcarea flor, calcarea fos, mag fos, all 30x potency. Also, we give medicines to improve the immunity level of the patient. And least but not the last, very good combinations are available. So which combination will help the patient, that can only be suggested after proper case taking. Now actually homeopathy people say homeopathy is slow. Is homeopathy slow? No. It is atom bomb. It's super fast. How? If you are having pain, medicines are given 2 to 1 week. Along with the exercise I give, one. And number two, medicines can be put in water and that water also can be drunk. Another thing is that when the history is taken, we take the history from childhood up to this age. Plus we go to the parental history, your mind, the tongue, the position of sleep, the perspiration, the urine. My dear friends, if you get in pregnancy, you also get a back pain. And even after surgery, you get a back pain if anesthesia is given. So during that time, the medication again will be different. After pregnancy, it may go into sepia. After surgery, it may go into arnica hypericum. So it will all differ from stage to stage. That is why a long history taking, looking at the tongue. The tongue is the reflection of the inner metabolism of your system. Plus looking at the eyes, looking whether the perspiration is yellow or white. Many persons while taking the history, my dear friends, actually feel very bad when they say perspiration is staining my clothes. There is no need to feel bad about it. Because the toxins out of the body are being thrown out only through the nose, through the ears, through the perspiration, through the urine and the stool. So these are the gateways of dirt. So allow it to go. So when you take a bath with the hot water, you may feel better at the muscular pain that is there at the back. Some persons also feel better with a cold pack. Now this will differ whether the patient is having a hot patient or a cold patient. How will you differentiate in that? If you want AC and if you are drinking cold chilled water, you are a hot patient. Many cases of acidity also have a back pain because acidity has a tendency to cause destruction into the bones. Now all this I am telling you because when I take the history, I come to know a patient is of acidity. Teeth will decay, bones will decay. Stop, work on the acid level, give alkali diet. Now what is alkali diet? Alkali diet is whatever you see green is all alkali. And stop using oil, only use ghee. So when you take an alkali diet, your whole inside metabolism is changing, and that's why you need to drink a lot of water to flush the toxins out of the body. I was talking to someone on the phone maybe 2-3 days back. They told me they take only 3 glasses of water irrespective of the pain. Only 3 glasses. So if you take more water, system will be flushed out. Another important thing I would like to tell you is looking at the rising sun. Very, very important. Everything will come to you. Vitamin D, all the minerals, whatever 5 elements are required, you name it and it is there. How to look at the sun? See, this way you do, this way you do. Put it below the navel. Again, I repeat, do like this. And do like this. Make a ring. You know, like this. This is what my Surya Yoga Guruji had taught me. Like this. And put it below the navel. Okay? And look at the rising sun. Hardly 2 minutes. And if you don't remember this, don't do this. It's okay. Just look at the rising sun or the setting sun. But not at 12 o'clock, please. This will help you quite a lot. The whole system will have a lot of power. A lot of power will come into your whole system. You may say that I feel drained out because of back pain. Your energy levels will be stabilized. Your weakness will be less. Lot of things will start happening. But provided you will start acting onto it. So to summarize everything what we have said, the summary is, in short, any pain is nature's call. Respect your body, value your body, pay attention, take action according to the causes given, and be alert and start working. This is my only request to you on humanity grounds, and your backache will not remain for a long time. And please, whenever anyone tells you anything, receive with an open mind. Do not listen with a biased mind. What is a biased mind? Your previous experience with the previous doctor was like this, A, B, C, not narrating anything. But don't become biased. A new person is with a new experience from whatever field they come. So, the best way is to listen and take action. There are many anti-inflammatory foods also which I usually say, but right now I can just give you this only. Another thing which I have always told patients to do is consume lot of haldi. That will be anti-inflammatory. And I have told you Saragwa ka Singh, what is easily done. And a lot of milk will also help with dry fruits, haldi and honey in it. You see, we are looking, there are 2 things. Either you go through the process or you want instant coffee. The exercises which I have showed are actually many a times instant coffee also, because that I have taken from Dr.Sonal Motta. And again, diet I have implemented so that the whole system can be flushed out. We have taken homeopathy, we have taken mindset. So if everything is being applied, my dear friends, I really feel that you have to be a winner in backache. And the grace of the Almighty definitely will help you. So, the grace of Almighty follows. Let your grace be there on the body. And I end this session saying thank you. to Madam Anita and to Dr. Malpani, and paying all my last respect to Dr. Malpani, who has passed away, actually made a beautiful platform for humanity to view on. Thank you very much, everyone.
Help Talks are daily health-related talks held at Health Education Library for People, Mumbai, India. For more information, visit www.healthlibrary.com. Subscribe to Help Talks channel. Be better informed about your health.